Let's get smashed tonight.
Oh, yeah, let's get fucking drunk.
We're gonna get fucking drunk.
Wait, I'm gonna get so fucking drunk.
If there's one thing the evidence shows, it's that Australia is a nation of drunks, is the general conclusion of our country's doctors. That's why the Royal Australasian College of Physicians is calling for some serious national changes to reduce alcohol consumption.
We're gonna get drunk. Drunk.
In a submission to a Senate inquiry on drunken violence, the RACP recommended raising the legal drinking age, introducing early closing laws in all states, more power for councils to reduce licensed premises, lowering the driver blood alcohol limit to eventually zero, banning sports sponsorship by alcohol companies, and placing health warnings on alcohol products.
That's a lot of information to get in 30 seconds.
It is, prompting one David Linehelm to respond, I want to say colourfully.
Hey doctors, you're not qualified in public policy. Shut the fuck up.
I'm sorry, I just started hearing really loud circus music in my head. What did you say?
Shut the fuck up.
Alrighty then.
Yeah, that was a state senator telling a bunch of doctors to
shut the fuck up!
But that aside, it did get us thinking about the role of doctors in public policy.
Now, David doesn't dig doctors, or more specifically, doesn't dig their public push for lockouts in Queensland and New South Wales.
Doctors demanding lockouts because they don't like treating the victims of violence is equivalent to teachers demanding parents keep dumb kids at home.
You know, that's just like your opinion, man.
Indeed! Except when it comes to opinions, there's none more trusted than the opinion of someone wearing this hat. A 2013 Roy Morgan poll found doctors and nurses were the two most trusted professions in Australia. So when a collective of doctors says,
Australians have a problem with alcohol,
we're likely to believe them, even though national alcohol consumption and young adult binge drinking have been steadily declining for decades. The Senate inquiry is currently taking submissions from across the board, but its ultimate decision will come down to whether it believes that some opinions are more equal than others.